All right, let's move a little bit on CAMSUR, sir. So, because a lot of questions came in last night, and I want to ask you this. Were you really railroading the passage of the bill? Go ahead.
Well, better for you to ask any of the senators if I ever talk to them.
Okay.
To vote one way or the other on the CAMSUR bill. All I did was to tell them, please conduct the hearings already so that we can dispose of this because there are interested members of the House of Representatives. And this is common among members of the House of Representatives.
All right. Senator,
come to us.
In an interview with ANC, I'll read this. Governor El Rey Villafuerte, of course, was interviewed, and we all know that they're they're in war with his father. But he had said this to ANC. My father and Enrile are fraternity brothers in Sigma Rho. Let me just continue. My father has been going to the Senate every day, lobbying and pushing for this bill, hopefully before the filing of the certificates of candidacy. Let's not divide the province just for self-interest, referring to his father.
That's true. I never deny that Louis is a friend of mine way back. We were members of the Marcos cabinet. We were together in the Mr. and Miss magazine, which spawned another newspaper.
Okay.
And then he helped me in my political activities.
Okay.
Loli de Fuente Bella was a member of the Nacionalista Party. Mm-hmm. I was a member of the Nacionalista Party. But I this is common. The Bukidnon, the redistricting, the people there came to me, even the MILF, they came to me when we were discussing
so
the
So he is lobbying with you?
Huh?
See, Villafuerte, the older Villafuerte.
No, they were not lobbying. They were just asking me if I could possibly exercise my position, my leadership, to finally bring this matter to a vote so that it can be disposed of. After all, Karen, this issue will not be decided by the Senate. It will be decided by the people of
Camarines. Because there's a plebiscite.
There's a plebiscite.
Yes. Okay, very quickly, Senator Marcos was quoted as saying, I'm reading from the Inquirer right today, approving the bill on second reading despite Trillanes' pending manifestation would set a dangerous precedent that could be invoked to rush other measures. Marcos complained of pressure from parties for and against the bill, but that would not be you. But then he said, was there an effort to approve the bill on second reading, Senator, despite Trillanes' pending manifestation?
Well, there was a request.
Okay.
But I said, we have to follow our procedure.
Mm-mm.
And that is why yesterday we adjourned without passing the bill.
Okay. Do you think the bill will ever be passed?
I don't know.
Okay. Are you for the separation or the passage of the bill, frankly?
I do not normally vote.
Oh, you don't vote?
Unless there is a tie. But I have no preference one way or the other. Maybe I will vote in favor to give the people of Camarines Norte a chance to decide for themselves. Who am I to impede that?
Okay. All right. Now, very quickly, before we go to a quick break, Senator Trillanes had implied the former GMA Arroyo connection. Sorry for the word, but he
said
you were a lackey. That's the word he used, huh? I'm quoting.
You know, I've been a friend of all the presidents.
Okay.
All the way to Magsaysay, all the way to President Quirino. I knew them. They were coming to our house in Malabon.
Now, some people had said this was to protect Dato Arroyo's district, but then in Villafuerte, the younger one, had said the bill will not affect Dato's district. So I'm curious.
I don't know that Mrs. Arroyo or the Arroyos were interested in this bill. They never approached me or they never talked to me.